Good morning, my dear students. I hope you all are good. My dear students, today we are going to start a formal letter, and you have done informal letter. And formal letter is actually the part of persuasive writing, and there are three types of persuasive writing: persuasive speech, informal letter, and then formal letter. You are done with persuasive speech and informal letter, and today we are going to talk about formal letter. The learning objective of this is to be able to write a formal letter in proper format and using persuasive techniques. We are going to know some persuasive techniques, and then we will be knowing the proper format of formal letter. On second slide, we can see that persuasive techniques. There are some persuasive techniques written here. The very first is rule of three. Rule of three means you are supposed to write three consecutive adjectives to describe one noun. Rule of three means you have to write three consecutive adjectives to describe one noun. Second one is rhetorical question. Rhetorical question means a question that does not need any answer. A question that is asked but that does not need any answer in return. These are some techniques that you are very well familiar with. These are not new for you, but I'm just revising these techniques just to make you understand and just to make you more clear idea. Third technique is repetition. Repetition means when one word, one phrase, one clause, or one whole sentence is repeated many times in the whole text, and it can be repeated twice or more than two times. So that this technique is called repetition. Then anecdote. Anecdote means you are supposed to share any experience from your past, any personal experience related to that topic. So this is called anecdote. Then direct address. Direct address means you are addressing the person whom you are writing a letter. Direct address means you are using his name, or you are using like you. If you say you are doing this thing, like I am addressing you people as you people are sitting in front of me. So it means I am using the technique of direct address. I'm addressing you people. In the same way, you are supposed to address the other person whom you are writing a letter, and you are supposed to use this direct address as the next person is sitting with you. Next, exaggeration. Exaggeration means you have to exaggerate the things. You have to explain the things more than it needed. You have to explain the things. You have to explain any point, the point which you are talking about. Flattery. Flattery means you have to do a little bit buttering of the person whom you are writing a letter. This formal letter is written to a person who is having some authority, a person who is sitting on a particular seat, who is having a particular designation. This is different from the informal letter. Informal letter is always written to your friends, family members, or your relatives, or a person whom you are very well personal to. But in formal letter, you are supposed to write very formal language. You are supposed to be very respective, and you have to give honor to the next person whom you are writing a letter. So flattery is what you are doing, a little bit buttering of the person whom you are writing a letter, and it can be the flattery of the principal if you are writing a letter to a principal. Then alliteration. Alliteration means the use of same consonant sound more than one times in a whole sentence. Use of one consonant sound. I am talking about consonant. Use of one consonant sound more than one times in a whole line, in a whole sentence. The next is emotive language. Emotive language is the language that is used to make you emotional. And emotional does not mean that if someone is getting emotional, it does not mean that he or she is sad. It means all the emotions like sadness, happiness, excitement, anger. So these sort of things. So emotive language is the language that is used to make someone emotional about something. The last technique that you can use in formal letter is undermine opposing views. Like you are undermining the view that is opposite to you. Undermining means that you are weakening you are negating and you are proving the opposite's view as opposite. Opposing view means if someone is having a view, if someone is having a point that does not suit you, so you are supposed to negate that point and you are supposed to prove yourself that you are correct. So these are some techniques that are used in formal letter. Now we will talk about the format of formal letter, because the format is one of the most important things in this whole letter. We can say that if we talk about the content or the format, half marks would be of the format and half marks would be of the content. Like if the letter is of 10 marks, the teachers are supposed to give you 5 marks of format and 5 marks of the content of the body of the text. There are different parts of the format of the text. The very first is sender's address. You are supposed to write sender's address, then date, then receiver's address, then greetings, then body, then closing, and then signature. We are going to discuss them one by one in next slides. If we talk about the sender's address is actually, the sender's address is usually put on the top left corner of the page. Like in your page, just with the margin line of on left side, on the top left corner of the page, sender's address is written. The address should be complete and accurate in case the recipient of the letter wishes to get in touch with the sender or for further communication. Like if the other person wants to write you a letter back, so there should be some address of you so that he or she can write you back. So sender's address can be written like this: house number 3A block. This is the example I have written here. But after writing this house number and block or street, you have to insert a comma here. Comma is important. Then you have to write your colony name or the road name or wherever you live, like Said Colony, comma Canal Road. And yes, at last here the comma is again important. And then on third line you are supposed to write city name Faisalabad, and after Faisalabad this full stop is compulsory. After writing the sender's address, you have to leave one line, you have to skip one empty line, and then you have to write the date. The sender's address is followed by the date after skipping one line. This is important. You have to write sender's address on top left corner of the page, then leave one empty line, and then you will write the date. And date, there can be any date, like if it can be the date on which letter is being written. It is important in formal letters as they are often kept on record. Like if you are writing a letter to some authority, if you are writing a letter to the principal, so that letter would be kept in record. So that's why you are supposed to write the date. This is compulsory to write the date. Try to follow the British way of writing the date. And what is the British way? This 13th April 2020. There is no comma here inside this date, and I know most of the students insert comma after 13 or after April. No comma is written here. Only a full stop is given. Only a full stop is inserted at the end of the date. So please keep this way of writing the date in your mind, because this is the approved British way of writing the date. And wherever you are writing the date, try to write like this, because this is the best way to write the date. After writing the date, again you have to leave the space of one line, you have to skip one empty line, and then you have to write receiver's address. Like after leaving space of one line, again leaving the space of one line is important. If you don't leave the space of one line, it means you are not following the format of formal letter. After leaving space of one line, we write the receiver's address on the same side. The same side means on the left side you are supposed to write receiver's address after the date. Make sure you write the formal title, name, position, etc. of the receiver. Like if you are writing a letter to the principal, you have to write like title, your title is the principal, or you can use the name, or you can use the position of that person. As the first line of the address, for example, like this example is given like the principal, comma. Comma is again important here. Please don't forget to insert comma here. Then Lahore Grammar School, comma. Then Canal Road Campus, comma. And then Faisalabad, full stop. This, the use of these commas on first three lines and then the use of full stop at the last is an important thing. Please keep it in your mind. If you talk about the greetings, greeting is there. This is where you greet the person you are addressing the letter to. You have to write, you have to give the greetings to the person whom you are writing a letter. Bear in mind that it is a formal letter, so the greeting must be respectful and not too personal. Like you cannot use dear principal, no, because this will become too personal. You have to be quite respectful. So you can say sir, madam. Simply you can say sir or madam, or you can also say respected sir, comma, respected madam, comma. Again, the use of comma here is important. And yes, one thing more, before you write respected ma'am or respected sir, you are supposed to leave one empty line. Again you have to write, again you have to leave the space of one line. Then again, after writing greetings, you are supposed to leave one more empty line before writing the body. Body is the next step after writing the greetings. So before writing the body, again skip one empty line. Here comes the body. Body of the text means the main content of the letter. The main content of the letter, the whole thing, what you are writing about, body is actually the reason of why you are writing the letter to the person, why you are writing the formal letter. Either divided into three paragraphs or two, this formal letter, this body can be divided into two if the letter is short, if the content is short. But it is encouraged to write in three paragraphs. Minimum three paragraphs should be there in your body of formal letter. Next, the purpose of the letter should be made clear in the first paragraph. Like if you are writing a letter for some particular purpose, that you should be clear in your purpose, in your topic. Next, formal tone. Formal tone means you are to be very respective, and don't use the word dear, or don't use the word so fluently. Just think before you write something, because you are writing a letter to a person who is having an authority and who is sitting on a particular designation. Then flattery is again an important thing. You have to do the flattery of that person. Like you can appreciate that person, you can praise that person, you can talk about the good things about that person. So this is all about flattery. Then concise and to the point. Your body should be concise and to the point. Like you are not supposed to give so many extra details. Just write to the point and write concise. Concise means to the point. Be respectful and considerate in the language, no matter the subject of the letter. It does not matter what is the subject or what is the topic of the letter. No, what matters is actually you have to be respectful and considerate in your choice of language. If you talk about the closing of the letter, at the end of the formal letter, write a complimentary losing on the left side of the page by leaving the space of one line. Again, when you will end your body, when you will end writing three paragraphs, you are supposed to leave one line after the body of the letter, and then you have to write closing. You have to give closing remark like yours faithfully, comma, yours sincerely, comma. Again, this comma is very important in this format, whether you are writing faithfully or whether you are writing sincerely. After that, you must insert comma here. This is so important. Next comes signature. Signature means leave one line after closing and then write your name in block letters under that. This is how the recipient will know who is sending the letter. Now, as you know, like in the start of the lecture, in the start of lesson, when you start writing the formal letter, you did not tell your own name, just you gave your own address. So here comes the place when you have tried your name. After leaving one line, this after you faithfully or you sincerely leave one line, and then you can write your name in block letters. So this is all about the format of formal letter. Now it's your turn. You have to write a letter to the principal of your school, persuading her to arrange online classes for the students in order to let them stay connected to the studies. Like, this is quite a relevant topic, what you are learning nowadays. This is quite a relevant topic to this. Now you are supposed to write a letter to persuade the principal of your school to arrange online classes for the students. I know that you are already having online classes, but in case you are not having the online classes, you have to persuade your principal to arrange online classes for the students so that they may be connected to our studies. So this is all about today's lecture. I hope you have got each and everything. Now take your creative writing notebooks and start writing this homework, start writing this formal letter, and please keep in mind all the persuasive techniques and the format of formal letter. Then write it carefully, and if you have any other question, you can ask us in comments. So thank you so much. Inshallah, we'll see you soon.